Hi there, welcome back to GP Reactions. I hope you're well, hope you're having a great day. And as always, thanks to everybody that subscribed. So now I'm going to be reacting to Steve Hackett. I don't think I've reacted to any Steve Hackett for a while. And this is a song I'm not familiar with, at least I think I'm not familiar with. It's called Spectral Mornings, and it's a title track, so it's taken from the album of the same name. And Spectral Mornings was released in May 1979, which was a year before Defector, if I'm not mistaken. And Spectral Mornings is Steve Hackett's third studio album. So, and the personnel on this album was Steve Hackett on guitars, Pete Hicks on vocals, and all other tracks. You've got Dick Cadbury on bass, Mick Magnus on the keyboards, and John Hackett, and guess that's his brother, who plays a variety of flutes on the album. So without further ado, I'm really looking forward to this. I like the album cover, that looks quite frosty and cold. And it's, I suppose it's kind of congruous with this time of year, to this like frosty cold effect. We had a little bit of snow the other day, and as I looked up through the glass on the bus shelter, it had the same kind of effect, which is pretty cool. Without further ado, Steve Hackett and Spectral Mornings.
Thank you.
You know, I mean, I've heard a couple of tracks, few tracks now of Defector, and I think this rivals anything on there. It's such an otherworldly sound that he produces. It's so distinctive to him. When you think about like bands like Genesis or any band really, where the guitarist goes off to make albums by himself, he leaves the band. You would maybe kind of think that's the guitarist is, you know, done now, and whatever he plays is going to, I don't know, just like melt away into a background into a greater band. And clearly, he's working with some great musicians, but that guitar, it's really got his stamp on it. It's just so incredibly distinctive, his style of playing. And I don't think I've ever heard a guitarist play like Steve Hackett. And this is such a strange song. So I was thinking halfway through, if I was to maybe describe this song to somebody and say, I have this instrumental, and I wasn't sure whether there were going to be lyrics on it. But to say, if I had this instrumental and it repeats itself two or three times throughout the song, I'd probably say, yeah, I think I'll probably give that one a miss. But it never feels tired. There are subtle changes. There are changes in the guitar. There are changes in the drums. And I'm no musical expert, so I can't really maybe pinpoint what they are, but there's enough variety in the instruments around the body of the melody that it keeps it really, really fresh. And every time you kind of look forward, I mean, after the first couple of peaks and troughs, I really look forward to that euphoric guitar. And it was just incredible towards the end to hear the way it just kept rising and rising and rising. And it's hard to say what this song kind of makes me feel like, because at the very beginning, and I was looking at the cover and I was thinking of the other day when we had a dusting of snow, and I was looking through the, and it was cold, I was on my own, and I was looking through the roof of the bus shelter I was in, and it was like frosty snow effect on the glass top of the shelter. And so when I first heard the beginning of the song, it did feel like a winter's morning, when you kind of wake up and the world's waking up. And I was just kind of picturing in my mind's eye is a cover of Frost looking over fields. I always get this feeling with Steve Hackett's songs about expanse and looking out on an expanse of, I don't know, nature, countryside, of land, of a realm, perhaps. It really kind of evokes different feelings for different people. And it's just as well I'm not a musician, because I think that's the overall feeling I take away from it, is a very simple one of euphoria, atmosphere, expanse. And yeah, it's just such a beautiful song. I'm so glad I listened to this. I am, you know, if you watch my channel, you know that I've listened to a lot of Genesis tracks. Some have featured Steve Hackett, and some haven't. And really, now I'm thinking about Genesis and Steve Hackett as together, and as viable separate entities. I need to check out something more from this album now. I haven't quite finished with Defector. I think I've got a few tracks left on that, but I think I need to check out something from this album, Spectral Mornings. And I was thinking about timeline, actually, and this is the third studio album, so that means he's already completed two albums since, I believe, he left in 1977. I'm assuming it's 1977. I think that was Genesis' last album with him, which may have been either Wind and Rothering or A Trick of a Tail. I'm not really sure which one came first, but the only person I actually missed out on this was the drummer. So if anybody knows who the drummer is, I think I gave a drummer a mention on the Defector album. So is this the same drummer? on this album as it was on Defector. If you want to join me in the comments, please let me know. But also, if you want to join me in the comments and suggest anything else from this album I might listen to, I would be really, really glad to hear from you. And also, please, you're welcome to slap me on the wrist if this is a if this is an album with like a theme that runs all the way through it. Maybe it's even a concept album that everything has a sequence. Maybe it's telling a story. If it has, I apologize. This was just one track that kind of jumped out at me. And I know my brother and his friends have, they were really, really into this music back in the day. And my brother had obviously had Defector. And I'm sure that this, subconsciously, this Spectral Mornings track has been mentioned. Initially, when I looked at 6 minutes 32 seconds, I thought, is this going to be too long? Am I going to enjoy this? And even though it did repeat, clearly it was such a fantastically fresh song that it really held my interest. I love the rest in between. I think that was really important, the melody, that the calm melody in between. It gave us a chance to relax, to recoup, before we went right back into that euphoric guitar and drum. Amazing track, guys. I'm really glad I listened to it. So please let me know. Join me in the comments below. I really love your comments. And till next time, take care of yourselves and have a great day and a great week.